Thank you for joining the King's Daughter Prayer and Testimony Service with your host, Evangelist Lazina Johnson. You can reach the ministry at 313-229-0849. Also broadcasting every Friday at 6 p.m. on licmc.net radio. Also available on Facebook Live, the King's Daughter Prayer and Testimony Service with your host, Evangelist Lazina Johnson.
Glory to God. This is the day that the Lord has made. Hallelujah. Let's rejoice and be glad in it. It is finally Friday. Hallelujah. Freebie Friday. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Amen. Thankful Friday. Hallelujah. It's another day. It's another day. It's another week. That we done made it through. Hallelujah. God's been good to us.
Yeah.
He woke us up this morning and he started us on our way. He clothed us in our right mind. Hallelujah. With the activities of our limbs, we was able to move about today and do what we wanted to do. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. I want to give you praise this morning. I mean, this afternoon, this evening, all day long. I want to give you praise. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. I'm Evangelist Lazina Johnson. Just want to tell you thank you this morning. Thank you, Lord Jesus, for waking me up. This is the prayer line. If you need prayer today, give me a call, 313-229-0849. Oh, I know that you got something to say this week. I know God done did some wonderful things for you this week, because he done did some wonderful things for me. And I know he done did some wonderful things for you. Oh, I know he have. Give me a call and give me a testimony today. Tell me all about it. Tell me what God has did for you. Because I know you've been had your armor on all week long. And everything has been going good because you've been you've been on the battlefield and you've been fighting that good fight of faith. Huh? Because from last week, I know you prayed through last week. And God delivered you and brought you through. Huh? Did he do it for you? I know he did. If you trusted him, if you called on him, did you pray? Did you pray? Because if you pray, God answers. Because God answers prayer. Do you believe me? Try me. See if God won't answer your prayer. Get on your knees today. Let's just thank God for another week, another day, another hour, another minute. Because we didn't do this on our own. We didn't wake up by ourselves. He woke us up this morning. He breathed his breath of life into us. So we need to be thankful today and give him all the glory and all the praise. I don't know what you've been going through this week. You might have had a rough week. Some of y'all might have had a pretty easy week. You know, we go through ups and downs. But I don't know what your situation is. But whatever it is, be grateful in it all, because it could have been worse. It could have been worse. And then some people had it real bad. You know, they might have lost a loved one. You know, and that's inevitable because, you know, we come here, we were born to die. So, you know, we can't mourn like the world mourns. We celebrate the life. We got to learn to celebrate the life and cherish the life that was given to us for us to have in our lives. And we have to be grateful for their lives. So if you lost a loved one, my condolences go out to you. My heart goes out to you. And I am praying for your strength in the Lord, because God is good. He is a keeper, and he will keep you through it all. He's that footprint in that sand. You think you carry yourself? No, 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 no. No, 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 no. You're not carrying yourself. God is carrying you. He's carrying you through all of those hard times, when you're going through rough times, and you just don't know which way to go. God is right there waiting. Carry you through. All he needs you to do is just say, Father, I need your help. Can you get on your knees today and thank him? And if you need him, call on him. He's right there. Call on him. Call on the name of Jesus. Tell him to help you to get through. He'll help you to get right. He'll help you to do right. He's a keeper, I'm telling you. Get on this side of the road. Accept Jesus Christ in your life. But he is the bread of life. Accept him into your life and exchange, give him yours. Exchange your life for his. Because he is rich and full of grace and full of mercy. And you'll have joy, unspeakable joy every day. Because when you think on those things, those are the things that you should have. He said, you can have what you say when you're on this side. Your life has, your tongue has life. You can speak things into existence, even though they may not be right now. But if you speak it, it will come to pass. Because the Bible tells you, you can have what you say. So you need to give your life to Jesus today. The invitation is open. The door is open. The phone is line is open. You can call 313-229-0849 and let the good Lord come on in and let him and do something for you, because he's been waiting for you. He's been waiting right there at the door all the time. You wouldn't let him in. But would you let him into your heart today? Let him into your heart today. Trust him. Trust him in your heart and let him in. He'll work the thing out. You don't know which way to go. You need the wisdom of God. Let him lead you and guide you. Let him direct your path. Let him lead your footsteps in the right direction. Because he will. He will. If you don't know what to do, try God. Just keep on praying. And be patient and wait for your answer. Because you will get it in due time and in due season. He ain't never late now. He ain't going to be late. You know how we be late on the light bills and the gas bills sometimes? We be late. We be late going to work, late going to school, late doing this, late doing that. But one person that I know ain't never late, and that's God. He's always on time. You can trust him. He's a perfect person. He's the only one perfect in the, that came on this earth. He's the perfect one because he's God. God, I said, he is God. And he left us the Holy Spirit to help lead us and guide us. After he went to heaven, and he's sitting on the throne, he's praying for you. Now, if Jesus is praying for you, you ain't got nothing to worry about. All you got to do is just get on the knees and lay at his altar and tell him all about it. And he is praying for you. And if he's praying for your situation, then he's going to work it out for you. Can you believe that today? Put on the whole armor of God and see, don't he cover you? See, won't he walk with you and talk with you? Believe in him. Stand up today. Make a public announcement today. Let the whole world know that you're sick and tired of being sick and tired of being sick and tired. And come to Jesus. What's that old song? Come to Jesus. Come to Jesus. Come to Jesus right now. Right now. Don't wait. Don't wait till it's too late. Because once you close your eyes, it's too late. It's irreversible. You got to make your decision on this side of the earth. Of life while you still got breath to breathe in your body, because once that breath is gone out, it's all over and it's said and done. So today is your day to make a decision. Jesus knocking at the door. Would you open up your heart and let him in today? The invitation stands open. The door is open for you right now. Come on in. Come on, come on, come on. I know somebody needs him today. I know I need him every day. Oh, Lord, I need you, Jesus. I need you. I need you every day, each and every day, and each and every minute. Can't live without you. Oh, Lord, do you know where you're going when you leave this earth? Do you know after 3 minutes that you did, your eyes going to open up? You're going to be, either you're going to be in heaven or you're going to be in hell. Choose you this day. Choose today what side you want to be on. Do you want to be on the Lord's side? Or do you want to be on the devil's side? Lucifer, Satan, the evil one. Or do you want to be on God's side? Jesus and the Holy Spirit helping you to move about and do things on this earth and have joy on this side of the earth. Can you trust God today with your heart? Can you trust him? He can be trusted. He's faithful. I'm telling you, he's faithful. I'm going to tell you what he did for me one time. I'm going to give you a testimony. You know, my granddaughter, she was graduating. She wanted a dress. Her mother said, well, okay, I'll get you a dress. So she went out and she spent a couple hundred dollars on a dress. She That's all she said that she could afford it. She thought it was nice that she brought it home. She showed it to her daughter. Her daughter said, yeah, I like the dress. This is not the one that I want. And she said, Granny, can you go with me to that, you know, that real expensive place where they sell all those fancy dresses? Can you go with me out there? I just want to look and see if they got anything I like. Okay, so okay, sure, let's go. We went, she looked, and she found. Of course she was going to find, right? Dresses cost $1,000. Of course she going to find one. They expensive. You know, you got good taste. We got good taste. You know, we got caviar taste with beer prices, with beer money. All right. So then, look, I had faith in God that he was going to do it because she graduated. You know, she graduated. This is a special moment in her life. She want to wear what she want to wear for her prom. So I'm like, okay, Kari. She finds a dress. It's $900. Ooh, Lord Jesus. And I'm like, oh my God. That's the whole house note right there. I'm like, oh, well, but she wanted. And she said, well, Mama, what we gonna do? I said, you know, God got it, okay? If you want it, God got it. If you can believe with me that God gonna get you this dress, then God gonna do it for you. She said, I can believe, Mama, I want this dress. She said, this is the one I want. I said, this is the one you want, this is the one you gonna get. So we looked and we looked and we looked and we looked in my purse and we didn't have much money. We had about $150, but it was going to take $300 for us to put the dress even in layaway for her to even get the dress alterated. Now, this is the last week of the prom. We ain't got no time now. We down to the final moments. So now, it's like a week before prom. You know, we in there and it's the week before. So we had to come up with $300. She said, well, my mom ain't going to give us $150. I said, oh, yes, she is. She going to give us that $150. She said, I don't think she's going to do it because she had already bought me the dress. I said, well, don't worry about that. I said, I know she's going to give me $150 because that's my daughter. I'm going to call her, and she gonna send us that money. I called her. But sure enough, just like I said, she said, you need what? I said, I need $150. Because I need to put this $150 with the $150 I got so that we can get Kari this dress.
Would you go up there and let him know how I'm broke, man?
What
he calling you?
Yes, and I'm telling you right now, God has been so good. He opened up the door. He made sure we got that money. When that girl came to get me, we went back to get that dress, order that dress. She was so excited, and we was counting up the money. We was just counting up the money, and then all of a sudden, I was like, Kari, I don't think we got enough money, but we kept counting that money, and sure enough, God had done, seemed like he miraculously made that money multiply, and we had enough money, because we had to come back with $600, because we put $300 down, but I was counting, every time I counted, I was counting $400, but then when we finally counted it all up, we had the $600, and we got that dress, and she was so happy. Oh, my God. God was so faithful. And I'm telling you, we was on our way there. We was praising God for the money, and the song came on Faithful. So I'm telling you, God is faithful. If you just trust and believe on God, it's faithful. Do you believe today? Can you trust and believe that God is faithful, and he will deliver you, and he will set you free now? And he'll give you the desires of your heart if you can just trust him. Today is the day. Open up your heart and trust him. Can you please do that for me? Do it for you. Do it for me. Let's do it together. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come. Thy will be done on this earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, O God. Forgive us of our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. Father, we ask that you purify our hearts today, that you take out everything that's not like you, that you fill us with your spirit, that you deliver us, O God, from evil. Hallelujah, hallelujah. For thy is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever and ever. And we ask that the Holy Spirit will endow us and fill us with his spirit. Teach us the way, show us the way, help us to walk the walk and talk the talk. clear the pathway, oh God. Remove every hindrance and every stumbling block, that we may be able to walk with you, Jesus, and walk with you and talk with you. Fill us, oh God. Open our ears and our eyes and our understanding to your word, even the more as we continue to walk the walk of faith. As we walk this walk of faith, I say, it's a faith walk. You got to believe. You got to believe. You got to believe and trust God is going to do it. When you pray, believe it. If you ain't gonna believe it, then don't pray it. That's what my grandfather told me. He said, if you're going to pray, then believe it. Pray it and leave it there. And get up and just believe that God has already done it. That's what he told me. Now, if you do like my grandfather told me to do, and that's the way I've been living my life, God has always answered my prayers. And he'll answer yours too. Because he's no respecter person. Can you believe him today? That he can deliver you and set you free. I don't care what you're bound by. He said, come as you are. He didn't say come as a perfect person. Because if you was perfect, then you wouldn't need Jesus. You wouldn't need God. Everything be perfect around here. But that's not the way it is. This world gone wild. I said it again. This world gone wild. And you know it. I heard a preacher say it. I had to steal that from him. I said, world gone wild. Oh, yeah, it's gone wild. It's gone crazy. It's crazy out here. And you got to pray because you need your covering. You got to get on this side so God can cover you and watch over you and protect you and keep you from the fiery darts and the evil one that walks through day and through night. Give your life to Jesus today. Before it's too late. Don't let the enemy sneak in and steal your life before you've made your decision. Yeah, I know you're doing this and that and everything else, and you think God don't already know what you're doing. He knows. He knows you. He knew you before you knew yourself. He knew you. So if you come to him and he saved you, you better be grateful. Hallelujah. You need to be grateful because I know I am. I'm grateful. I was a chief sinner out here. I was doing it up. Doing it up. Partying, doing it up. Okay? Doing it up. I thank God for this grace. And you can have this grace too today. Now, can you pray? Call me. 313-229-0849. This is Evangelist Lazina Johnson. Call me Mama Z. I'll pray with you. Today is your day. Choose him today. Walk in that door. Open up that heart. Let him in. The invitation is open and the door is to come on down, 10300 Puritan. We'll pray with you. We'll pray you through. I don't care what you're going through. We know the situations because we've probably been through them too, or something similar to it. And we know how to pray you through. Come down to 10300 Puritan on Wednesday nights at 7 o'clock. Get your oil. Come on down. We'll touch you with the oil of God, with the olive oil, with the anointing. And we'll pray and ask the Holy Spirit to move on your behalf. Because we can't do it. We have to pray and ask God to do it for you. But we will embark on heaven for you. Hallelujah. I say hallelujah, hallelujah. We will embark on heaven for you. So come on down. Give me a call. Or come and see me. Whichever way it is. We having a prayer breakfast in May. If you want to come to that, it's May the 29th. From 10 to 2. All you can eat. Donation is just $10. And we're going to build up a home for men and for women and children. Whoever needs help, we want to give them some shelter, clothes. We're going to feed them. Just like God said for us to do. We're trying to do the work over here. God is good. God is good, I said. He's good. He's good. He's good. He's good. He's so good. He's better than camel soup. If you can do it, you can believe it. If you can believe it, God is good all the time. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Glory to God. Glory, 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 glory. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Glory to God. Praise his name. Today is your day. I said, today is your day. Today is your day for prayer. Come to Jesus. Come to Jesus right now. Come to Jesus, I said. Come to Jesus right now. And he'll change your life. He'll take that old life of yours, that old dirty life, that old messed up life that you wouldn't want to get rid of. Give it to him. And he'll give you his. A glorious royal life. You'll be a royal, in a royal family of the royal priesthood. Hallelujah. In the name of Jesus, today is the day. The door is open. And the prayer line is to call right now. 313-229-0849. And then, hey, that prayer is good. Anytime, you can use that number anytime. Call for prayer. God is able to deliver and set you free. Come to Jesus. I said, come to Jesus right now. I wish I could sing that song. I could just hear it down in my belly. Come to Jesus. Come to Jesus. Come to Jesus right now. He's the best thing going. He's the best thing ever happened to me. And he'll be the best thing ever happened to you. How about that? He's the best thing. Jesus is the best thing. Have you heard about it? He died on the cross for you. For the remission of your sins and mine too. Yes, thank you, Lord. Thank you. Thank you, God, for your son. Hallelujah. And thank you for the Holy Ghost. Thank you. That teaches us all things and bring back all things to our remembrance. It leads us and guides us in all truth and all righteousness. For his name's sake, he said. Ha! Glory to God. Another bullshot. God deliver somebody today. Somebody calling on your name. Deliver today and set them free. Deliver and set free today, God. Heal the sick and the shut in today. Meet them in their needs. Touch somebody everywhere. Touch your lost and the sick. Touch the lost, oh God. Touch the mentally disturbed, the mental ill. Be with them, oh God. Give them peace in their minds, peace in their souls, and peace in their spirit. Help the children of that God and cover them and keep them. Help them to understand and be able to be smart and be in school and learn all that they can learn and be able to can it and retain it. I thank you for that. I thank you. And I give you praise in Jesus' name. Amen. For God is our good shepherd and he watches over us. Why don't you let him watch over you today in a different way? Why don't you let him touch you today? One touch with Jesus will make it all right. Believe me, it can be done. He touched me, he can touch you. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Give him praise today. Give him glory. You can't say nothing but just thank you. Just thank him. Just say thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you, thank you for another day. Thank you for keeping me. Thank you for bringing me back home at my appointed place where I left from. Whole and not broken. Thank you, Lord. You kept me from all incidents and coincidences all day long. Kept me from snapping on somebody that did me wrong. God, I thank you that you gave me peace. And for those that even missed the mark, forgive them that missed the mark today. forgive those that missed the mark today. Yes, Lord, forgive them. Forgive them. Give them another chance to make the mark, to make that mark in the high calling according in your word, Lord. Jesus, have grace and mercy on us today and every day, God. For you are a prayer answering God. You are a prayer answering God. So I'm telling you, if you need what you need, what you need, what you need, God got it. It's all at the table. That's the name of our prayer breakfast. It's at the table. Everything you need is going to be at the table. Whatever you need joy, you need peace, you need love, whatever you need, it's at the table. Whatever you need is there. He has it. It's nothing missing and nothing broken in God. Everything you need, your life is there. Your whole life is in the book. You just ain't found yourself yet. But you need to find yourself in the book. Because you definitely are in there. From the foundation of the world, you was there. Yep. 2,000 some years ago, 3,000 some years ago. Yeah, you was there. I was too. I was in the volume of that book. That B-I-L-E-B. That B-I-B-L-E. Amen. In that Bible. That basic instruction before leaving earth. We got to get the instructions, y'all. Because we don't know how to live down here on this earth the way God wants us to. The way he intended it for us to. So we need to learn. We need to learn how to live this life. And walk this walk. Trust God today. Let him start teaching you how to live. As you know, we done messed up enough. We done had enough. I know I got full to my capacity, so I couldn't take it no more. I just had to holler out, help me. I can't live like this. I can't live in fear. No, I couldn't live in fear. And I was so afraid to die. Oh, my God. But without Jesus in my life, I never would have made it. Never would have made it. Never would have made it this far if it was not for the Lord. If it was not for the Lord, I wouldn't have made it this far. I've been on a journey for a long time, and I ain't tired yet, I say. I'm not tired yet. I'm working for Jesus now, and I just got started. I've been working. But I'm really getting started. I'm ready to run now. Time to run for Jesus, y'all. We got to run for him. He done did it all for us. He done died for us. So can we run for him and tell somebody about somebody who is somebody that can do something for somebody that can't nobody else do? Tell somebody about Jesus. Let him do it for you, and then you'll have to fire it in. Because I'm telling you, once he touch you, no doubt about it. You won't have no more doubts. If you doubt now, Thomas, you won't doubt then. One touch from Jesus and you will never doubt again. Yeah. Ooh, I'm telling you. I know a lot of people doubt God. They don't believe. But I tell you one thing, let them get in trouble. First thing they say is Jesus. But guess what? His grace and his mercy, he'll come right there. But I don't want to be hollering forever. I don't want to be hollering Jesus 2 minutes. I want him to holler the first time and he hit me. I don't want to holler 2 or 3 times. You know, that closer walk with him, you know, you can just holler Jesus, he'd be right there. But if that you ain't walking that walk with him, he kind of far off, he'd be calling on him, and he'd be there. But shoot. He'd be like, the first thing you got to say is, Lord, I need you. Forgive me. You got to repent. So why don't you go ahead and do that today? Get that on out the way. Get that out the way. Give Jesus your heart. Make him the Lord of your life today. Get all that other stuff out the way. Do that. And start right there. Make him Lord of your life. And Father, forgive me of my sins. For For I have sinned against only you. Wash me and make me whole. Cleanse me from all my evil doing and all my unrighteous doing, God. Cleanse me and make me whole. Set my feet on solid ground. Not on the sinking sand, God, because I've been sinking and sinking fast. But I need you to lift me up and stand me up. Get me off my knees. Get me off my face. Lord Jesus, help me today. Forgive me. Wash me. Let it be done today, Lord. Please forgive. Please forgive me. Because I truly believe that you died on the cross and rose again for the remission of my sins. And as of this right now, hey, you say, you can confess with your mouth and believe it in your heart that he died and he rose again. He said he was saving. Now it's time for you to start learning and walking. Find a good Bible church, a teaching church, church filled with the Spirit of God. And learn, learn, learn how to walk this beautiful walk. Because I tell you, it gets sweeter and sweeter as the days go by. Yeah. Yeah, it might start out a little rough because you don't know what you're doing. You don't know how to access nothing. You're ignorant to his ways. But the more you're with him, the better you get. It gets the sweeter and sweeter, I think, as the days go by. So choose today. Once you start today, start your walk today. Start your walk today. Let Jesus in. Let him in. The door is open. Come on down to 10300 Puritan on Wednesdays at 7 o'clock. You need a touch. You need somebody to pray. You need to push. You need somebody to lay hands on you, push you in your back, in your stomach, whatever it is. You need deliverance. This is the hospital to come to. 10300 Puritan, the corner of Griggs. The doors open at 1:30 on Sundays. And service starts at 2. Come on down. Come on down. I said the door is open for you. Yeah, I'm talking to you. And you too. Don't think I'm missing you. I ain't missing you either. You can come too. All are welcome. All are welcome to come to the house of God. Come and pray with us. Because we're trying to pray to God every day. If we can't let a day go by that we don't speak to the good Lord and tell him thank you. There's your day. Can you tell him thank you? For delivering you and setting you free today. I said today was Free Me Friday. I know you want to be free. I know you want to be free. You're getting ready now. You're getting ready now. You want to be free. You want to get free from all that stress from all week long. You're trying to get free right now. Ain't no telling what you're trying to do. But I tell you one thing. You better choose God and put him first. Choose God. And put him first. I said, choose God and put him first. And everything else is second to him. Put God first and let him deliver you and set you free. Walk the walk today. Walk that walk. Come on down to the altar. Come to the altar. And hold on to Jesus' hand. And never let it go. Never let it go, I say. Never let go. That's what my grandmama told me. She said, stay with God. She said, whatever you do, stay with God. And that's what I'm going to tell you. In our final moments, stay with God. In Jesus' name we pray. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Because I'm going to stay with him. I ain't got no other choice. I ain't got nowhere else to go. I'm definitely not going back to the devil. No, no, no. Because I done had my fill. When I left him alone. Because I done had enough of his mess. He had tore my life up. Tore it up. And I let him. Because I didn't know no better. But don't you let him tear your life up. Give your life to Jesus. Give your life to Jesus. And he'll make things much better. Better than it is now, and it gets better as the days go by. When you can just trust God and believe in him, today is your day. Yes, today, what's the day, April 1st, today is my baby's birthday, my deceased baby, yep, died. April the 1st, she was born April the 1st, and she died April the 1st, day of her birthday, April Fool's Day. I don't play no joke on this day, this ain't no joke right here, this ain't no joke that Jesus saved, this ain't no joke, April Fool's Day, justice day, just is praying for her mama in heaven, I'll see her on the other side. Somebody else out there may have been a lost child. We'll see them on the other side. Let them be an inspiration for you to make it to heaven. Because that's what my inspiration is. My Jesse is my inspiration. Yeah, I got a lot of loved ones that's been going on. But that baby, oh my God. That hurt it. And I know you might be hurt too. Hurt real bad. So this world, like I said, it's gone wild. There's a lot of wild things happening. Things you wouldn't even believe is happening to people. Good people too. People you say, oh no, that's a good person. I know they good. Just bad things happen to good people too. Yeah, it does. But we, you know, God, we need him to cover us and keep us. Hey, because when we run into that evil one, we need that protection. We need to be able to hold up that shield. I told you about that armor. You got to put that armor on, y'all. Put your armor on today. Ephesians. Look it up. It'll tell you. Ephesians 4. Put on the whole armor of God. So you can be able to stand and stand against the evil in this world. Because it's gone, like I told you, it's gone crazy. It's gone cuckoo crazy. It's gone wild. Hey, you don't believe me, just look at the news. If you look at that news is depression. It's so much happening today. We don't love one another. We just don't care about one another no more. Love doesn't seem like ain't no love no more. Where is the love today? These young people, we got to pray for the young. Y'all pray that these young people mind. They just act like they're 5 years old. Jesus, have mercy on them. Have mercy on their soul today. These young people, God, touch their mind. And let them know this is not no video game. This is real life. And they can't take one because they can't give one. Can you do it? Oh, Lord, let's pray about that. We got a whole lot to pray for, y'all. This prayer line should be full. Calls calling in 24/7. Somebody should be calling for prayer. You know, I don't care how little it is, how big it is. God, you need to pray, man. We always got something to pray for. I don't care if you're praying for your toothache, your headache. It's something to pray for. Your foot ache, your back ache, your stomach ache, whatever that's hurting, whatever the situation is. You lost your job, need a job, got to have a car, bought a car, got to live it, whatever. They did this, they did that, whatever it is. We got something to pray for. But prayer is the only place I've ever went to in the church and it was packed. and prayer should be the number one thing packed. Wasn't even just as much as Sunday service. Because that's when you need to be on your face, communicating with God, telling him all about your trouble, your situation, and then listening to what he has to say to you about your situation and your things that's going on in your life. So, come to prayer on Wednesdays. Come to prayer on Wednesdays. Come to prayer on Wednesdays at 7 o'clock. Get here at 6:30. Get on your face before we start the corporate prayer. Get here. Come on. You got something to pray for. Come to the house of God. You know, it's something when we all come together and pray too. It's something to hear the prayers of the saints as other people are praying. It helps you. It helps you just like it helps me. I know that. I love to hear other people pray. It gives me strength. But sometimes when you're weak and you can't even muster up a prayer, just to hear somebody else pray gives you strength. Gives you strength. You can gain strength from listening to somebody else's prayer. And praising God. And oh Lord, when they tap into the spirit, oh yes, we all can catch hold and fly up with them. They can usher us up with them when somebody tap into the holies of holies and they usher on up into the holies of holies. Oh my God. Ain't nothing like it, y'all. Nothing. You need to come on. And get on this side, I'm telling you. Ain't nothing like God. Nothing. He's a deliverer. He has set you free. And he has set your feet on, I'm telling you, on that solid ground. He got your back. He got your back. Yeah. He got your back. Put stumbling through life. Falling down. Getting up. Falling down. Going around the same old barbed bush. Aren't you tired? Aren't you tired? Every time you push the elevator, it keep going past the floor that you want to get off on. Man, push that button. Push the right button. Push Jesus' button. And he'll take you as high as you want to go. High as you want to go, I tell you. He got the best high in the world. I know some of y'all about to go get high tonight. Drinking and smoking and doing whatever y'all like to do. Pills, whatever. But ain't no high until you had a high with Jesus. Ain't no party until you had the Holy Ghost party, y'all. Because it don't stop. I tell you. Them feet get to dancing. Whew. Yeah. You think you dancing now out there at the club. You get down. You partying. You shaking it loose. Wait till the Holy Ghost get a hold to you. You ain't dancing until you done dance in the Holy Ghost. You ain't had nothing until you done experience God. I'm telling you. Jesus, have mercy. Have mercy on our souls today. And forevermore, have mercy on us. Open up the ears, Lord, that they can hear Jesus. They're calling. I'm calling them. Come on. Come on. Come to Jesus and come right now. Ooh, you just don't know how sweet it is to be loved by Jesus. How sweet it is to be loved by him. Have you ever had somebody to love you? Maybe you ain't even had nobody ever love you before. I'm telling you, love is hard to find, especially these days. Like I said, love is very hard to find. True love. Love, unconditional love. You know, that love. That love. That when I wake up in the morning, that love, you know, that bad breath love. They love you even in that bad breath. That kind of love, you know, in spite of it all. In spite of how bad that hair looked on them bad hair days. Oh, my goodness, you know. When you done gained too much weight, you know, them bad, them days like that. You done got fat. Then, you know, yeah. You used to be slim, but now you done got fat, you know. Unconditional love, regardless of what.
Thank you for joining the King's Daughter Prayer and Testimony Service with your host, Evangelist Lazina Johnson. You can reach the ministry at 313-229-0849. Also broadcasting every Friday at 6 p.m. on LICMC.net radio. Also available on Facebook Live. The King's Daughter Prayer and Testimony Service with your host, Evangelist Lazina Johnson.